Is there a car? Okay, that
she
was
quick. Gotta see the red light.
Band, but she fell. Red means stop. No means no, and...
Oh, I gotta go that way?
Yeah.
Oh, my bad, bro. He was like, yo, what are these niggas doing? He's not even supposed to be parked here.
Yeah, right? Act like you know.
Hey, what's going on, folks? We are coming at you live from Oppa. That's the name of my car. If you don't name your car, you have fucking issues.
Oppa from the Avatar?
Yeah.
Wow, that's dope.
My car is white, like Oppa, so I named my car Oppa.
I like that.
But yeah, we coming at y'all with a new episode of the How'd I Get Here podcast. We are trying something a little new and a little different this season. We ain't going to be in the car every day, but I thought it would be dope that, you know, music has played an important part in all of everybody's lives. So it'd be dope to just chop it up and see where the conversation goes based around music.
And it's a new season.
Wait, which did I hit the right sound effect? Oh, green light, green light, green light. Hey guys, don't try this shit. Don't drink and drive. Be safe. Don't try this at home.
Facts.
This first song coming at you is a Galway Girl by Ed Sheeran. This was my pick. Believe it or not, I only picked one J. Cole song. So
this playlist is gonna get wild.
It's gonna get weird, but
I'm gonna have some explanations. I'm sure you're gonna have some explaining.
Oh yeah, there's gonna be some stories. But Galway Girl, my man Charlie, who all the listeners who've been with us from the beginning, season one, two, blah blah. He was actually there when I came up with the idea for the podcast. A British dude, and on our road trip to Denver, is when I started fucking with this song. So it was just a little bit of nostalgia. And like, for me, music, I can't sing for shit unless I'm in the shower.
Them acoustics hit different.
What? But this song brings me back to like that road trip, the relationship that me and Charlie built, living in Boston, which was a imperative year. I mean, every year is important, but that was that song.
A monumental year.
It was different, bro. I didn't know. I had just got out of a relationship. I didn't know what the fuck I was getting into. I was still chasing a dream. It was different. It was different.
Dope. Hey. This is Cam Envato. This is me.
Now, did you pick this because of
the verses?
The verses?
No, so it's funny. This was actually a wild time in my life. This is when I was really in these streets, busting corners.
You're not in the streets no more?
Yeah, nah, I'm outside. I'm inside. I'm domesticated. I just explained that to somebody today. Like, yeah, I'm no longer outside. I'm domesticated.
I'm still outside.
But I remember driving around in South Windsor with
the mean streets of South Windsor.
The mean streets of SW.
Is that what they call it?
Nah, I just made that up. And this girl was in my car. So it's me, my boy Jay, and like these two girls in my car. And when he says, huh, in the chorus, she was like, huh? Hilarious. But this was I have a Jadakiss song. So I've always been a Jadakiss fan. I don't know if we talked about this, but I knew the Lox was gonna body Dipset.
Oh, for sure.
Like, it wasn't even gonna be close.
For
but,
sure.
You know, people, well, as my boy Strett said, anyone who thinks Dipset's gonna win never left the porch as a kid.
Do shots fired.
Yeah, right. So this is dope. So we tried to bring a new dynamic to the new season. We just finished what I think was a dope first season together, collaborating.
There's something, I mean to cut you off, something that I'm going to bring to this season is a swear jar. Ooh. Every time I swear, I'm going to put $1 in the jar. And by the end of the season, whatever is in that jar is going to go to some charity.
Okay.
I haven't decided what charity.
Charitable donations.
But yeah, we're gonna try and keep this. I was gonna say this. We're gonna try and keep this clean.
Yeah, try to keep it PG. Just so we found that, at least I heard from a lot of people, they want to listen to it in the cars with their families. But and I quote, we're told that we have some prolific language. So, you know.
That was probably you, because you were using them big words.
Nah, I didn't say it. My boy said
no,
it.
No, but I'm saying, when they said prolific, they meant you.
Oh. But yeah, no. So shit, what you want to chop it up about today?
Oh, this is you too. What is this? Is this a anime song?
Nah, this is Seosin. This is actually like
my
favorite band. It's my favorite band and my favorite song. I used to be able to play this on the drums.
You played the drums?
Yeah.
You know, music is very, very therapeutic. Believe it or not, I played the clarinet when I was in elementary school.
Wow.
But I didn't really play. I learned hot cross buns. Yeah. And then whenever we would go to all the concerts, I would pretend like I was blowing into the clarinet and just move my fingers because I never practiced it ever. So
the band teacher was definitely like, this dude is not
garbage. Yeah, nah, but this brings me back to like Linkin Park. And it's funny to like bringing it back to like the verses and stuff. A lot of people was like, oh, I remember being in elementary school listening to the locks and this, and I'm like, bro, I was listening to the Backstreet Boys and
for real,
bro, I just Linkin Park, like I was I heard the Jadas, the 50s when they came out,
yeah,
but I wasn't on all that, for lack of better terms. Well, I was gonna say hood shit, but
Urban. Oh, that's a dollar.
Is shit really a curse word?
Yeah, if you gotta ask, you know it is.
By the way, we are really just driving right now.
Yeah, we really like, just.
I need y'all to understand. I don't know where I'm going.
We on the South End.
Gang. Another thing I need to work on this year is my petty. For the end of the year is my pettiness.
Ooh.
Let's talk about that. I don't think there's nothing wrong with pettiness, because although pettiness might be petty, it might get you to the answers that you are seeking, or the questions that you are looking for.
Pettiness?
Because it's going to strike a nerve with people.
So
it's like poking the bear.
I guess it depends on your level of petty. My pettiness is like, I want my pettiness to be felt to the core. Like, if I'm going to be petty, I want it to hurt.
See, but I'm not malicious with my petty.
I know.
I'm funny with my shit.
I want my petty. $3. Yeah, I want my petty to be like, I didn't acknowledge it the first time something happened, the second time, the third time. I'm going to wait till you forgot, until something comes up and they're like, damn, wow, I guess I missed out, huh? I guess so. At that point, I'm not really thinking about it. My pettiness is my success. And to you, it's going to hurt. And to me, deep down, wherever I am, I'm going to feel great. Not that I'm maliciously doing it, but one day I might think about it sipping like a drink on a beach with my lady, like, ha! Look who missed out.
See, for me, my pettiness is like, I want you to think about that right now. Like, I'm not gonna say nothing disrespectful, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna just come for you in a way that, like, dang, I really have to think about what I did, or how can I get back, or ooh, that was a good one. You know what I mean? Because like, I could stoop to lows, but you ain't gonna stoop lower than me.
It's true. I play the long game. I feel like up front is too easy. Okay. This is you.
No, this is me for sure. This brings me back to England. Living in England, house music was huge.
Oh.
And I remember being there and like coming from Hartford, all we doing is grinding, reggae, Spanish music. So I'm like, how do I dance to this? And that, you know what I, no, nah, but they used to kill it. And I used
for
to
real?
Be,
oh,
bro,
like shuffling?
Yo, they used to shuffle hard.
Oh, okay.
And I never, when I first got there, I was like, I'm not coordinated. I can't do that. What are you doing?
My ankles run.
Bro, seriously. They go in one direction, left, forward. But, yo, shuffling in England is when I really, like, I think started to diversify my music.
Okay.
And get into, like, different genres. Cause this, I know every word to this song, every single word. So I get it into this.
I wish we had a camera to then like show what we're viewing, because it's crazy.
We're gonna ask people what they think about these songs.
I wanted to
not them.
The piece.
Yeah, that's a good shout. Not them. But
because normally I'm quick to roll my window down and say something, but.
Oh. You got to show me.
Should we try to get someone to come up to the window to talk?
Maybe not here.
Maybe not this neighborhood.
Yes, but no.
Top Cat Slum, Super Laundromat. So if you're on the South End and you know about Top Cat Laundromat, you know where you're at.
Yeah. What would you say music does for you therapeutically?
So it really... And I feel like I have undiagnosed ADHD, so it really like it calms my brain. So me, if I want to like zone out and really get into my thoughts, I turn on rock music.
Really?
Yeah, because I play the drums and I love playing the drums. Well, I used to play the drums. I love playing the drums to rock music. It's just very upbeat, high tempo, quick. So me, I'm thinking about the beat and what I'd be doing while I'm playing. And then naturally, like when you're a musician, you can play your instrument and then think about other things. Like I used to play for hours at a time.
That's like doing two things at once.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
You gotta think about playing the drums, like you're doing like four things at the same time.
Oh, okay, that's a fact. That's a fact.
So your brain, I think, automatically just learns to compartmentalize what it's doing. So yeah, I'll be playing and then I'll be thinking about something. Like, so as a kid, when you used to do homework, did you listen to music? Did you do homework?
That part. I did, but when I was doing my master's, by the way, y'all, I got my master's at 22 years old. Fuck with me, I know I got it. No Magic Johnson.
Oh, that's $4.
Fuck it.
$5.
Got you. No, but when I would do my master, when I was studying for my master's, doing my dissertation and everything, I would put on like music with like pianos, violins and stuff.
Oh, like classical music.
Yes, but like classical with a bit of like pop, because it would like help me focus. And that, like, I could put on J. Cole, I could put on Nas, like some of my favorite artists, and I couldn't focus. But if I could put on classical with like a little bit of like funk or jazz, I would literally, like you were saying, zone out.
Wait, why couldn't you focus listening to like your favorite artists?
I don't know. I don't know if it's because I would like start singing lyrics or like my mind was just focused with like...
Let me know.
Right, exactly.
So, all right, I actually have a question. So when you listen to music, at what point are you listening to the lyrics, and does it depend on the artist and the genre?
For me, at first, I'm not listening to the lyrics. I'm just listening to the song, right?
As a whole.
As a whole. Okay. Let me listen to this work of art, right? Mm. Oh, I like the beat. Oh,
Whoa. Hey,
I told you I was going all around with the playlist. Going all around with it. But the first, I just listen to see if I like the song. And then from there, like if I'm listening to Cole, all right, let me try and hear the lyrics.
Okay.
You know what I mean? The lyrics come after. But let me see, hear this work of art as a whole.
See, if it's Cole, I'm listening for the lyrics the first time.
But I can't, I know I'm not going to catch the lyrics.
That's why I'm listening. Like, For Your Eyes Only, that album, that story, the story that he tells from the beginning to the end.
Amazing.
It's dope.
But like, I knew I wasn't going to get that on the first listen.
And most... That's a great point. You know why? Because most people, they don't get it after the 10th listen, and then they're like,
yeah, J. Cole's not that good of an artist.
Right. I want to go listen to Drake.
Yeah. Well, first of all, so we have to, like, you got to give Drake his acknowledgement, because think about who he could realistically go in a versus with in our generation.
Chris Brown.
And who's going to keep up? No, not even close. No one's keeping up with Drake in a versus.
Kanye.
No.
That's wild.
Bro,
20 songs back to back, I think Chris Brown and Kanye could compete with Drake.
I think...
And I'm not even saying Cole.
Nah, because I don't think Cole's popular enough to go against Drake.
Right, right.
But I think any artist, maybe their first 10 to 15, but that last five... Yo, Drake has the most number ones in our generation. Yeah, he's got like 6 albums in... I forgot. We looked it up when I was at the barbershop. Yo, he's got bops. He's not my favorite artist. I don't really listen to him like that. But you got to acknowledge, you got, like, nobody, maybe Lil Wayne. Well, Lil Wayne, yeah. Lil Wayne's probably gonna body anybody in a versus.
I still think Chris Brown and Drake. I'm not saying now.
In a versus?
In a versus, Chris Brown.
He doesn't have the catalog.
Oh, but he does. Think about it, Chris Brown all the way back to Run It. All the way back to Yo. From there, the only reason Chris Brown is not as big as Drake is because he has multiple, like, flaws. You get what I'm saying?
Because he hits one.
Right. Yeah. We ain't gonna get into that.
You can't hit Riri.
I mean, she hit him first, but we ain't gonna get into that. Not justifying it, but yeah. Neither here nor there.
No means no.
Right. Like that dude told us, but pause. But still, like, he's got that. He's got, like, getting in trouble with the law. You know what I mean? Yeah. If he had, like, a spotless thing, like, record or whatever, I guarantee you he'd be up there with Drake. Because he had to take time off.
Why?
Because that's what society dictates.
If you... No. So if you get in trouble with the law as an artist, you need to take time off. Like, if...
To Hugh, DaBaby, right now.
I'm sure he's in his bag right now. He's probably...
He's definitely not in his bag. He got kicked off of every tour. But
when I say...
that he's...
Because some of the tours that they were making up, it's like, he got kicked off Kids Bop, like, 2023. But you got to think, because he's in such a... Wow.
Told you, I wasn't picking anything that just ordered. Let me ask you a question. What does music tell about a person?
Ooh.
Can you tell about a person based off their music?
Yeah, if they're well-rounded. Like, my lady, love her to death, but, like, I don't really rock with her music. The music that she listens to, like, right. it's not my favorite, but I understand why, because she's an artist, and the artist she listens to is, like, replicates what she wants to do. So, but I think music tells you, I feel like music and someone's intellectual level go hand in hand, and also what they're willing to listen to, because I'm willing to listen to anything if it's good. Like,
right.
Obviously, I'm not turning on country. It's not my first thing. I worked in a country bar for like 3 or 4 years. And in my time there, it's like I did a bit. there might be 3 to 5 songs that I like.
Word.
Other than that, it's just not for me. But
I mean, Party in the USA is a great song.
Yo, funny shout out to Classical Magnet Soccer Team. So I think my sophomore junior year that song came out, and just so happens every game we were leaving, it was on the radio. So like we were, as an entire team, we were bopping on the bus to this song. Win or lose, buddy.
It's funny you say that. My sophomore year of college, that was the first song on our warm-up playlist that we played in our stadium. But it was so ironic because we were ranked 16th in the nation. So it was like, yo, these goofy dudes are coming out to this. And it was just spanking everybody.
For real?
And, bro, we were I'd add another daughter, assholes with it. Like, we were good and we knew we were good. You know what I mean? So it was like, we were like, what would you think a bunch of dudes coming out to Party in the USA are gonna do?
I would probably think they're nice.
Oh yeah, well, maybe that's what everybody knew, and then we came out and spanked them.
What are we doing?
Well, since we're talking about soccer, I grew up playing on the soccer field, so we're gonna drive by it. By the way, DTTM, don't talk to me, my man's clothing line, check him out. But yeah, I grew up playing on this soccer field right here. I wish you guys, because we're actually at Beachland Park. So growing up playing soccer, I probably didn't listen to much music before games as a kid. But I remember in high school, I had a set playlist of like 12 songs. And I always warmed up with my headphones. Until I got to club soccer at like 15. And this terrible coach that I had was like, you're not going to be able to warm up with music at the next level. Duh, which he was terribly wrong about. But yeah, it is. That's a bear. She's walking a bear. But yeah, so I grew up, I scored a lot of goals here. It's just a little nostalgic to just come back and look where I played, Beachland Park in West Hartford.
So next time we're going to have a camera that's like in the front.
Word. Front facing.
Yeah. Or like maybe those 360 cameras you can just put on the dash.
Oh, that's a fact. That's a fact. But nah, to your point, once I like started dating people more seriously, because music is a love language.
For sure. Did you ever used to send tracks to shorties?
I was always shy about it. Because I was like, what if it's a trash song? What if you've already heard it? What if, you know, this isn't what you want to hear?
Hey, this is me, 22-2's Hova. It's so funny, right? So, like, my first serious ex out of high school, she hit me up one day. She was like, yo, I just heard Climax by Usher. This should be our song. I'm like, all right, let me listen to it. And I'm like, did you listen to the lyrics? Like, this is not a good song for a relationship. She's like, no, it just sounds good. I'm like, okay.
So let me ask you a question. When you get with somebody, right?
Yeah.
This question is back to the pettiness, right?
Okay.
First question. If you're dating somebody and their favorite artist is SZA, for example, right? Are you still listening to SZA after y'all break up?
I didn't listen to SZA before.
No. But like, say you liked them, so you started listening to
their music. It depends. If I didn't listen to it beforehand, chances are I'm not.
But like me, I don't listen to Janae Aiko anymore.
I don't know why, but I'm sure
that's an off-camera conversation. Okay. What was that area code somewhere in New York?
Oh, Christ.
We're back.
Here we are again. So it's like, I will say there is, like, I actually have a playlist like of my life since I was probably like 22 that I continuously add songs onto. And there's a section of that playlist that's about 5 to 8 songs that I skip by just because I don't want to like
remember
that time of my life.
Right. You could delete them, bro.
I know, but it's the timeline for me. Because, like, I can go back. It's like a memory bank.
Word.
Slow down. So, yeah, to your point, if I didn't listen to him before, I'm probably not. Like, my girl's favorite artist is Kehlani.
Can I just acknowledge your growth? Because, like, you've said my lady, my girl, like...
I mean, it's official now. It's No.
No, I'm just saying, like, it's growth. Like, we've come a long way in a season.
Facts. Yeah, it was just my shorty for a long time. This person I'm talking to. Her favorite artist is Kehlani. If we ever broke up, there's still a couple Kehlani songs that bop, but I didn't listen to Kehlani before I knew her.
So, my theory is, you know you're over somebody when you can listen to a song that you guys was like, oh, this was our song. Yeah. The song reminds you of them, or it was their shit. $7. This is gonna get an expensive season.
Yeah, right. $7 at the first episode. We haven't done it.
But you know what I mean?
Yeah, I get that.
That's when I know I'm over somebody. Cause like one of my exes, she loves Music Soul Child, right?
Oh, yeah.
For a minute, I couldn't listen to Music Soul Child.
What? Teach me how to love my body.
But then, yo, so it was that one and I forgot the name of it, but when that came on one day and I listened to it, I was like, oh, I'm over her. Like, we good. I can't eat lights. We in West Hartford.
This is true. Damn, you would have made it. That was a long yellow light.
Yeah, it's a trap.
It's a trap.
All right. So this, I'm so happy this song just came on.
Okay.
Because this brings me to the point we were just talking about. So shout out Noy, Bloomfield's finest, went to high school with him.
I heard he's a stand-up guy.
Bro, he's dope. Went to high school. We weren't like best friends in high school, but he was cool people in high school. He came out with this song, Lucky, right? Okay. And I was actually had a girlfriend in 2016 when this came out. But I'd be lying to you if I said I didn't play it for about 5 other chicks after I broke up with that girl.
So when you say play it for them, like, what you mean?
Like, yo, you got in the car and then I'm sitting next to you and I start singing to you and, like, if you like it, like...
You sing to women?
Of course.
My lady has not heard my voice. Like,
why? I sing all the time.
I don't know. I feel like that's super intimate. Not to mention, I don't have a voice, and she's a singer. Like, I'm not about to just get shat on.
That's a fact. No, but my thing is, like, I want to, it's one of those, like, I'm showing myself being vulnerable with you.
Lucky tattoo. How long has that been there?
Who knows? I don't be in West Hartford.
This is still Hartford.
No, this is West Hartford.
This is Hartford. No, this is West Hartford. I'm lying. Yeah. I forgot. Past 7-Eleven.
Where the line is. I guess a lucky thing, man. Like, it's something. But yeah, I mean, to me, it's one of those things. Like, I mean, you know, I'm goofy.
She's scary.
Oh, she's
terrifying. That's a strong black woman.
It's one of those things that, like, it shows a sign of vulnerability. You know what I mean? Like, I know I can't sing, but I'm just having fun with you. Like, there was this one shorty I was speaking to. Shout out to her. We did karaoke in the car for 45 minutes one day.
Wow.
I mean, we were driving back from somewhere, but it's fun. Like, let me be silly. Let me joke around with you. And, like, I know I can't sing, but if I can have fun with you, I'm fucking amazing. $8. But you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, that's done. And that vulnerability builds that bond between y'all two. I mean, I'm a goofball with my lady behind closed doors.
Word. Best burgers right there, Plan B, not the pill.
Unless you put the Plan B in the... Never mind. Put it in the burger. Yo, can we talk about... Where did we just had breakfast at this place.
Effie's?
Never mind, I don't want to shit on somebody. But I don't know if I'd go back.
Why?
It just, like, the food wasn't that great.
I asked if it had seasoning.
It was breakfast food, so it's like, whatever. It's all right.
Jada.
This song, right? What? So my brothers, this is another reason why I grew up listening to this. My brother is 10 years older than me, 10 or 12 years older than me.
Interjection K-Bar. We've had
some nights here.
Some K-Bar here.
When you gonna take care of the people that take care of
George's Pizza right here, best pizza in Harvard. Go ahead, your brothers.
So like my brother is a hood, like street dude. Like if you've seen the movie Paid in Full, that's his life on repeat. So this is like all resonated with him. Like he was in Yonkers. I think he actually like met these dudes.
Oh really?
Yeah. So yeah, no, that's why I grew up listening to all this Cam and that. This is the trap music. Like Jeezy, I had this one song on repeat, I think, for an entire summer. It was like, Jeezy like to drink, Jeezy like to smoke, Jeezy like to mix, I'm a hammer with his
but
coke.
Did you know what you were really talking about when
yes.
you... Yes. Oh, okay. See, my thing is, I remember being in middle school singing the thong song and had no idea what a thong was.
What? You never seen the music video?
I saw the music video and I liked the butts, but
I didn't. Like, I don't understand.
She had dumps like a truck. Like, I was singing it all that, but had no idea what a thong was.
Hey, can we talk about that hook though? Like, that's the most ridiculous. She dumps like a truck.
It slaps though.
It does. It's like, it's a bop. The way Cisco hit that backflip on the beach, like,
man.
Unparalleled.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, music has so many hidden messages and feels in it, especially like today. The stuff that's in music today is no way was in what we were listening to.
Like, are you saying it's not as...
I think it's worse.
Yeah, I feel like DaBaby, I like his music, but he don't be saying shit. Look at the kitties.
Wow. You are a cat, man.
Bro, I wasn't like this until I owned them. Damn, they got all the cats right here.
Look at them, peasants.
Peasants. Street cats. They probably whoop my cats' asses. I didn't agree with the dollar, so. But yeah, no, I mean, I definitely like. How old's your older brother?
33.
33. All right, so he's 4 years older than you. My brothers, like I said, both of them are 10 and 12 years older than me. So I just, like, I experienced different things at a young age.
True.
Like, my brother's been in and out of jail since he was 18, which means I was 8 or 6. Right?
Right. So you were exposed to that life at a young age.
Yeah. like being in the car, he busting corners. I don't know what's going on. I'm just like, oh, I'm going for a ride with my brother.
Right.
This nigga stops a lot. Why so many people get in the car? But yeah, nah, it's neither here nor there. So, I think it was cute that I was told by a woman recently that guys used to send women mixtapes.
You never made a girl, by the way. Yo, I love how this is just segue. You never made a mixtape for a girl?
No.
Like, put an album together or nothing?
And gave it to her?
Yeah. Never. Bro, maybe I'm, that's just the Libra and the emotional.
I'm sure how I'm feeling. Here's 12 tracks to do so.
Literally, yes. Every time you hear this, and that brings you to my point, at my wedding, this song gonna play. This gonna play. I don't know why, but I just imagine my wedding being a big party.
Yeah.
Right? So my wife, she need to be down with the shits. $9, right? She need to be down, and this is gonna be the biggest, most epic swag surf of all swag surf. That's why this is on. Do you see yourself getting married?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah?
If I just slapped him, yeah.
Nah, I don't know. Some people are like, weddings is just a paper, you know, like signing documents. Yeah. Like,
nah, I definitely, I can see myself getting married.
For me, I want to get married, but it's one and done. you know what? Like,
I feel that, though.
If I can't be second, third, fourth, fifth marriages, like, if I don't get this right the first time, I can't play this at every wedding.
Facts. And knock on wood, I can't be a baby daddy. Like,
ooh, let's hit on that.
No knock to anybody, but personally, I couldn't do it. So it's like, yo, we might have to, this might be an antiquated.
There you go with them, what was it, voluptuous words, or what was it?
Voluptuous.
You know what you
prolific.
Said?
Prolific.
There you go, prolific.
Prolific just means, like, explicit. But, you know, like, it might be an older methodology, but, like, once we have kids together, like, we gonna make this work. Like, we just gonna have to figure
you stuck.
We just gonna have to figure this shit out.
You ain't getting out.
Yeah. We gonna do this thing called communicate.
Oh, and, people don't know about that.
Ooh, this was me. So, you know what? Okay. When I was, like, outside, like, talking to women a lot, this song would definitely be on. Like, if we was about to do something later and, like, we've been drinking and kicking it, this song is definitely coming on.
Okay. So you like to set the mood?
For sure. I was between this and Sweet Dreams, and I'm like, I'm going to go with this.
All right. Question. Do you listen to music while having sex?
If we're serious, you can't be doing shit like that with everybody. Because, man, it's like, to me, and I think I said this last season, bro, sex is, that's a completely different language. Like, we're communicating on a very different level. It's my favorite type of communication.
Oh, this line long. Now I go to another one.
There's like 10 different
Dunkins that I could have went to. Not the one in the hood, the dirty one.
Yeah, with the dude with the pink slides.
Yeah, them pink slides hard. Are you gonna talk to him?
Yeah, them slides is hard, my boy. I like those. What'd he say?
He said these shits ugly as fuck. Those don't count towards my curses. Those were not my words. Wow. Nah, you know what? I think the playlist has got to be different. Like I could throw on some music if we're having sex, right? But I don't. You not getting the same playlist as Bae.
I'm not. No, listen. If you're not Bae, there's just certain things I'm not partaking in. I'm just like.
Like sex?
No. It's like, it could be sex, but it's just sex. We're not, like, making love.
Right. But that's what I'm saying. Like, I could throw on some Slipknot. That's not intimate. That's just noise in the background. Whereas if I throw on Usher, we making love.
If that's the case, we just throwing the TV on. If I need background noise, we'll throw the TV on.
About to have sex with some Phineas and Ferb.
I don't know why we watching Nickelodeon, but.
Disney Channel, bro.
Oh, We'll throw on we'll throw on a movie. We can do that. But now you can't just like, my thing is you can't, and this is where people need to draw the line. You can't just be doing everything with everybody. Cause that's when shit gets misconstrued. It's like, wait, hold on, but you just I'm trying not to say something too vulgar. Like we spent all this time together. We had all these intimate moments, and now it's just
see
yesterday's news.
My bad. I agree with you. People, and I'm gonna try not to be petty, cause people are sensitive.
You can talk facts. Facts are facts.
See, but yeah, sometimes you speak facts and people ain't. Oh, you was being petty. Nah, I was speaking factual. But people are not. People are ready to go all in or do certain things, and then they're not ready to realize, like, oh, I did XYZ to make you feel this way, and this is why you feel it. You get what I'm trying to say?
And there's different, like, there's levels to it, like anything else, right? Whereas I think if you're just getting to know somebody, like, there's different vulnerable acts that you'll do. But I'm talking about when it comes to, like, intimate moments, like, bruh, if y'all just getting to know each other and y'all just, like, fucking here and there, like, you don't need to be lighting the candle, drinking, like, whiskey.
It sends mixed messages.
Yeah, it's like, no, listen, we're still transitioning into this. Like, if we really getting into it, like, men, there's some strokes, and you know what I'm talking about. There's some strokes that you're not supposed to be giving the run-of-the-mill women. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you have, like, if y'all just, like, y'all just having sex just to have sex, there's certain strokes that you got to give. There's different strokes for different folks. You know what I'm saying? You know? Because women are getting, like, I've been told that women are going to be like, whoa, hold on. Why was you doing all that if you didn't like me like that? Like, I thought everybody's eating the chips, you know? I thought everyone was having a good time here. Nah, that's not it. So there's a certain responsibility.
So would you say you shouldn't be having sex if your intentions are not there?
Yo, if we're, like, in a real mature society, like, you...
I ain't going to hold you. I don't know how this is going to come out,
yeah.
Right? But I've thought about stopping having sex until I find someone I'm in a relationship. I thought about it. That's as far as the thought went. But
you thought about stop having sex until you're in a relationship?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, if we're talking about, like, protecting our energy, that's in an ideal world, if we were 100% mature and reflective on ourselves, that's probably the way to do it, because I don't think you can genuinely give someone your all, spiritually, emotionally, physically, if you're sharing certain parts of you with other people. In my experience, I don't think that's possible. Like, I don't think I could do it. I know I can compartmentalize and section things off, but I can't give you 100% of me if I know my Tuesday appointment, like my regular Tuesday sex appointment, is around.
Well, that's what you gotta cut them off.
Yeah, facts. I guess, when do you cut them off?
So that part. That part. Because, my thing is this. If I like girl, right? Yeah. More than girl likes me, but we're dating. Do I cut my hoes off before her, or do I wait till she cuts them off? Is it a conversation to be had? At what point is it like, we're not moving too fast, we're on the same page? Like, because truth be told, we know someone's going to catch feelings before the other person.
Yeah.
Or stronger feelings.
I think it's...
Sorry, I had to change that. Wow. Ooh, turn this up. Hold on. This is a commercial break for all my people. If y'all don't like this song, you don't have
me
to.
Me and all my peeps.
But I like this song.
We always thought he was straight. I can't believe you skipped that last one. That hurt.
I didn't. It played for 3.5 minutes.
When he came to the business.
Yeah. Were you not listening?
But now.
I know. The intro is crazy.
Since we know
how wait till the beat drops. Y'all gonna like this. You ready?
It's how we feel.
Here we go.
Fuck Donald Trump.
Hey.
Hey. Fuck Donald Trump.
Hey.
Yeah, nigga, fuck
this is my
Donald
song.
Yeah, fuck
I pick
Donald
this one.
Trump.
I pick this one.
Yeah, and if you Donald like him,
Trump.
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
Yes.
Yeah.
I like white folks, but I don't like you.
All right, so getting back to, so I think at that point, like, when do you cut your hose off? I think when you, this is one song I wish I knew how to speak Spanish, because I would bop to it even more.
This is forever a hit.
Yeah, I think you do it basically when you get to the point where I don't want to hurt this person, and I know if they found out about what I'm doing, it would hurt them.
But what about yourself? Because what I'm finding is a lot of the time, someone is willing to commit a lot quicker than someone else. Yo, this Dunkin' Donuts closed?
Temporarily.
Wild. Don't get an accident.
That's a really good Dunkin' Donuts on Park Ave. I know we were over there.
Park Ave?
By Angelina's, the Shell station. It's almost by the corner of Flatbush.
Flatbush. Angelina's, the pizza and the sub spot? Where's your Dunkin' over? Oh!
Yeah, right there. Bet. I think it's next to a Subway.
Yeah. But here's my thing, like, you gotta protect yourself, right? Yeah. So I can't just keep being out here, you know, cutting people off and doing X, Y, Z if you're not willing to do the same. Because then I'm continuing to put myself out there, and in reality, I was just another puppet or another piece in your game.
So how does that conversation go? Like, yo, babe, like, you take her out to dinner, like, yo, listen, let's be transparent. I know you got hoes. You know I got hoes.
I was your hoe at one point.
Yeah, like, so when do we... when are we gonna decide, like, we're gonna be official, we're just gonna cut everybody off? But my thing is, like, you said you gotta protect yourself, but, like, yeah, at the end of the day, this goes back to protecting your energy. I feel like hoes, cutting them off, you could get them back if you needed to.
Yes and no.
And if you can't, it's like, there's plenty of fish in this city. This bop right here, when this came out,
he picked this, not me.
This was everything I needed at that time in my life, because I'm like, yeah, I feel like I was slighted by who I was working for. So I'm
what is this guy doing?
He's like, I feel like I was slighted by who I was working for. So I was listening to this every morning. I'm like, oh, they count me out, right? Bet I'm about to go off. But yeah, I mean, I feel like you can cut them off. It's tough. And it all depends on, too, is like, what type of relationships do you have with your side pieces? Like, are these, like, cool people that y'all just, like, kicking? Or are these just like, yo, I met you, we decided to touch each other's private parts. And
you just a little joint.
Yeah. YOLO. Not the Mitsubishi.
Good job, Oppa. Yep, yep.
Yeah. yo, you know what's so funny? You look like the Ice Nigga now.
I do not look like, not Katara. It was Katara, Aang, and Sokka.
Is that his name?
Sokka.
Yeah.
Come on, bro. I'm on my anime. Stop playing with me.
Avatar's like mild anime. He's like, I don't care. But yeah, I mean, I feel like, how does that conversation go? How are you going to address that with
I think it's one of those, like, it needs to be said but goes without being said. Like,
nah,
because it's like, like, yo, we know how deep we are. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, bro, at this point, we done some things, like, you shouldn't have nobody else. But my thing, to kind of, like, bring it back, right? If we're just getting to know each other, can you be mad if that person is talking to somebody else?
No. I kept it a stack with my lady when we first started talking, like, yo, go do your own thing. Like, I would, because I don't go into any situation planning on getting in a relationship. That's the last thing on my mind. I established this before. Like, I have to establish my best friend before we can be into in a relationship. So, yeah, I kept it a stack. So I was like, yeah, go do your thing. I respect the hell out of her for it because she would let me know. She like, yeah, just wanted to know I'm going on a date. I'm going on a date here. Like, all right, cool, have fun.
That nigga ain't me, though.
Yeah, facts. But that comes with a certain confidence and security in yourself. Ooh, this Bob right here. No! So, I like the original song.
Oh, did I not pick the original?
No. I picked this one. I picked this because this is a cover of the original song, and I like both of them, so I feel like I got two out of this one.
It's interesting because a lot of the times people are stereotyped. Oh, that's white people music. Oh, that's...
You speak white.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And, like, you would never think a guy or a person of your stature would be listening to May Day Parade.
Yeah. Most people don't know I listen to rock. Like, if you knew me on Snap back in the day, I used to
When you were huggy?
Yeah, when I was huggy. I guess I'm still hugging in some capacity.
Yo, my head hurts.
What? Oh, from the hole in it? Bro, my boy got stabbed at his... Yo, shout out Elijah, new coffee spot. That looking good, cuz.
September 10th, Samia Cafe. Soft opening. Check it out.
When this chorus hits...
So don't switch it.
Please don't. Last thing I remember was talking about cutting off your whatevers, but yeah, I mean, you say one thing that I thought was interesting that you just said was it's something that should be said but should go without saying.
Why do I know this song?
It's that Goye song.
There we go. You're having a lot of fun right there.
What? Bro, I'm like, when I move, I'm gonna buy a drum set. It's just gotta happen. But no, I think communication within you were talking about dating other people while you're in the talking stage. But I think communication should be, in a perfect world, it should be like, you should over-communicate.
Yeah, but I've learned that could be aggressive, overwhelming.
Well, in a perfect world, that's because, like, the other person receiving it has to understand, like, I'm just trying to fill you in on what's going on in my head. Like, don't take this any which way, because I'm going to think like this far beyond
right.
I stopped talking to you. I just want you to know this is my thought process.
This is how I think.
Yeah.
All right, I've heard enough. Another one.
My playlist is coming strong.
Another one.
How many did you pick? I picked 10. So you have 11 songs. 10. So you must have...
I think I picked... There was one song you had that was like the original and then like... I think it was like two versions of it. So I just was like, bam, bam, because I didn't know what I was doing.
So honestly, the last three should probably be you.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh, y'all get to hear my Duncan order.
So we're about to get Duncan, and then we're going to wrap up. Because we've been wasting my gas for almost an hour now. But it was worth it. It was fun. Fallout Boy, they've got that one song.
That one song.
That I know that was on the radio. Oh, I thought this was the line. Oh. You want a hot mocha mocha chocolate?
This is racist because I'm black. I got one every piece of chocolate.
Is that racist?
Yeah.
I technically can't be racist.
Why?
Based on the definition of the word.
Ooh, what's the definition of a racist?
Definition of the word is...
Have you met Uncle Ruckus?
He's technically not racist. He's just ignorant. Because the definition of the word, not word for word, but it's the majority are suppressing the minority is racism. I am not part of the majority. So I, by definition of the word, cannot be racist.
I never... That...
I mean, that's paraphrasing.
Yeah, I gotta look this up.
Yeah. That's why a lot of people say, like, people of color cannot technically be racist.
Because they're minorities.
Because we are the minority. Well, she's kind of cute.
feel the sweat. I burn the city. Gotta show you the light.
Oh, this my favorite J. Cole song. Oh. This song brings back so many emotions.
For real?
Yeah.
Are you getting anything?
Well, are we just gonna go through the drive-thru and get nothing?
I didn't know if you were getting anything.
Oh, were you getting something?
Yes, this was my idea.
Oh!
This is why we're at Dunkin'.
I thought you just wanted to talk to him.
No, I wanted to actually order something.
Oh, get something.
Did they talk yet?
Did you talk yet? No.
Apple cranberry?
They didn't talk yet.
Apple cranberry flavored Dunkin'? But why is it blue?
Because the what? Blue apples.
What?
What?
There's blue apples?
Are you high right now?
No.
Do you ever get nervous?
Sometimes.
I'm a penny how I want it, baby. Oh, this is my canvas.
Bro, so I remember
pumpkin spices, but
when this album came out, I was living in England and I was like going through a breakup. So this song I would just play and I'd be like,
how many relationships have you been in?
Three. That's no, it? Two. Spencer wants something.
Can I have a medium energy cold brew black with less ice?
All I heard was a medium less ice.
Medium energy cold brew black with less ice?
A medium energy cold brew less ice?
Yeah.
Do you have a double chocolate donut?
Give me 1 second and I'll check it out.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Ooh, that's what munchies she got too.
No.
Why?
It's against your diet.
Who's on a diet?
I don't know. They don't have munchkins. Not this late in the day.
Yeah, sweet. How many would you want?
You want one?
I want munchkins.
One of those. My big friend wants to know if you have munchkins.
Yep.
10 munchkins, blueberry and jelly.
10 munchkins, blueberry and jelly, please.
Okay, so for the munchkins, we have the jelly, the glaze, the chocolate.
So jelly and glazed.
Jelly and glazed, please.
Jelly and glazed?
Yes, ma'am.
And then did you want double chocolate?
Just one double chocolate, yes. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Well, there's a dollar on there I'll give you for my donut. Oh, should we ask them for a song?
Oh, she seems a little angry.
Not fun. Oh wow, because I called you my big friend and she's
she's like, I'm the big friend.
Listen, y'all.
I'm crying. So
we
gotta scan this.
Oh. We've been chopping it up for about an hour. Love you guys. This is much of the type of energy we're gonna be on for season 5.
Oh, we have a producer now.
We got a producer. We're looking for a camera person.
Please.
Anybody wants to get with us, join the team.
Who knows how to edit and is handy with TikTok.
Yes. Yeah. Emphasis on the TikTok.
Yeah. Preferably a millennial. Gen Z's a little wild.
Yeah.
We love y'all though.
But listen, we're coming August.
She's not the big one.
Stop it.
The one taking the order.
So, August 6th, we were supposed to do a live episode, but we're going to do that this season. Our 50th episode ever is coming next, so expect big things. But yo, this is beginning of something new, something different. We continue to elevate, continue to change. So, I got a thingy for you.
It worked? I think you got to give it us.
Thank you, Angie. Look at that smile. She got a nice smile.
Are you the one who took the order?
She doesn't want to talk to you, bro.
I don't care.
She's busy.
She's taking my money. She can talk to me.
No, she can't.
Angie, are you the one who took that order? Took our order?
No.
Oh, you were right. Bro.
Told you. If you have your favorite song, what is it?
My favorite song.
Favorite song. We're going to play it right now really loud and you got to sing to us.
No, that's not
going to
happen.
What you mean?
Okay. So what's your favorite song?
You don't want to know
because there's no. Oh. Oh, this took a wild turn.
Is it like In Sync? Like, what's your favorite song?
Did we pet? Old stuff? Gotcha. Well, this was fun. Don't break any hearts. Stay beautiful. Be safe. Did we get everything?
I believe so.
Okay, bye.
Yo, I'll be here.
She said, I'll be here recording. Damn, yo, you look like $11.
We gotta edit that. There ain't nobody recording.
But my thing is, like, what you mean you don't have a favorite? I listen to old stuff. So what do you listen to?
She said it was inappropriate.
It was the thong song.
I was gonna say that, but I didn't want to be like I was being disrespectful.
Talking about you only did one J. Cole song.
I love this song, bro. So this song, he sampled Lauryn Hill, Road to Zion, right? Which is an amazing song. I think Lauryn Hill is the greatest female artist of all time.
Interesting.
But with that being said, this man tells three different stories in this song, and I could connect to all three of them. And that's why Cole's my favorite artist, because I could relate to a lot of the music that he writes.
What are the three stories?
The first one is about his stepdad who raised him and cheated on his mom. So I can relate to that one. The second one is about a girl that he was dating, and then they broke up and he came back in town and she was married because she settled too soon for him while he was chasing his dream. So I can sympathize with that.
Did he take it down, or she just like got married?
No, she got married.
Okay, so
yeah.
Like,
so it was, he lost his shorty while he was chasing his dream. Mm-hmm. And then the third one was he lost the best friend to chasing a dream.
Did you lose a shorty for soccer?
Yes and no. I wouldn't say it was completely because of soccer, but I was dating somebody while I was playing soccer, and me focusing and prioritizing soccer definitely contributed to the dysfunctions in our relationship. I can own up to that.
Respect
that. Yeah, but no, he tells three different stories in this song, so... Oh, I should have went straight. But yeah.
You're going home.
Right. But yeah, so... This is what the energy we're on. We're gonna bring more humor, more genuine conversation, more dope conversations. We're gonna talk about feminism, relationships, social media. We're gonna talk about a lot.
Gender roles. If y'all listen to this, just get ready, because we want some topics and some insight on what y'all think gender roles should be in a relationship and in society.
And interact with us. We got to, yo, shout out Trey. Shout out my man Coach T that be responding and, you know, comments. And guys, share, tell your, if you like what we're doing, tell a friend to tell a friend to tell their mom. Let anybody know. I'm single, he's not. Just, bro, yo, holla at us, like my man Cole said. And I guess we finished with our 15 seconds. I mean, I don't know if you had something to say. And we finished with our 15 seconds of fame.
I don't got much. But yeah, no, this is the energy that we're coming with. We're definitely going to do another one in the car. This is a test run.
Go ahead, bro. Aww. No, go ahead.
That man bun look crazy.
His ears look crazy.
Wow,
disrespectful.
But other than that, that's pretty much it. Everybody stay positive, stay consistent, stay focused. I'm noticing day after day, I've been failing more often than not, but I'm also winning more. So keep falling, keep learning, and keep winning. Simple.
Word. Heard that. Oh, we haven't used the sound effects, though. So, me, be intentional, be transparent, and be able to accept not getting what you want. Three things in life, lessons that I'm learning right now.
That's tough.
No shade, it's all love, and spread love. And you know, we're all works in progress. I'm a work in progress. So with that being said, love yourself, love everybody, and stay brown. And if you're not brown, stay beautiful, because we all are.
Or just tan.
That too. This is a great song to end on.
I've never heard of this.
No, this is the album, Stormzy, England.
Young Black King, don't die on me. You my brother, you my keeper, I need you to keep an eye on me. Superheroes. We don't fight on the streets, walking around with all this pride on me. Shit's tough for us to really know that you can still rely on me.
All right, y'all. We're going to check y'all back every Friday, 7 a.m. Get with us.
You're the only ones that got rap. Us. I can never let my sister. You've been too strong for too long. Yes,
I'm sorry.